We're going to be taking a look at the Snap&Read iPad app, which is now available in the iTunes Store and can be downloaded to an individual iPad or managed by an administrator the same way that the Snap&Read Google Chrome extension is managed. I've already downloaded it so you can see to my toolbar at the bottom right. And next to it, you can see the icon for the Safari browser. And the big difference here is we're going to be using the Safari browser to open up the source document. So I'm going to tap Safari, and you can see I've already opened up an article about Jane Goodall that I'm interested in reading. And to move this into Snap&Read, I'm going to tap the Share button at the top right, which is the box with the arrow pointed up. And I'm going to see the Snap&Read icon in the Share window. I'm going to tap that, and then I'm going to say, yes, open this in Snap&Read. And the document is going to be moved over. So here, if I want to start reading information about Jane Goodall, the functionality is the exact same as it is in the Snap&Read Chrome extension. Tap the Read All button, and then tap anywhere within the document that you want to begin reading.
Jane Goodall. Facts, information, and articles about Jane Goodall, animal rights activist and a famous woman in history.
And then tap the speak button again to stop reading. And again, you can tap that button and tap anywhere within the document that you choose.
Achievements. Awarded the DBE in 2004.
And we're going to be able to read through the text. So once again, you just go into Safari, open up any document that you choose to read, and then send that document to Snap&Read, and it will be available for the user to be able to read. Now, one of the most powerful tools within Snap&Read is the ability to dynamically level text based on context and make it more recognizable or comprehensible for the reader. We have that same tool in Snap&Read in the iPad, and to use that tool, I'm just going to select whatever text I choose on the page. I can do the whole page or just part of it, doesn't really matter, but select that text. And then the second button down is the dynamic text leveling tool. Tap that, and it's going to convert text based on context. Anything that's been changed is italicized. So on the left-hand side, I see husband or wife. Tap on that, and I go back to the original word spouse. Tap on it again, and go back to the words that it's been converted to. Challenging things accomplished or completed, tap on that, and that's achievements. Tap on them again and go back to the text it's converted to. And we're going to read that as well.
Challenging things accomplished or completed.
Now to go back to the original text, I'm just going to tap the text leveling tool, and we're going to go back to the original text. Well, one of the things that people have also always found very valuable about Snap&Read is that we can read anything. And one way to bring content into Snap&Read is to use the built-in camera that's part of the iPad. And on the right-hand side in the toolbar, you can see the camera icon. I'm going to tap that, and that activates the camera. And I have a book here that I might want to make available to a student who's not going to be able to read it in its original form. So I'm just going to take a picture of that book or any text. Once I've taken that picture, you see down on the lower right-hand corner, there's a button that says Use the Photo, so I'm going to tap that, and now it's going to bring it into Snap&Read. And because this is an image, I'm going to use the Ocr Tool, which is the third button down on the right-hand side. I'm going to tap that, and now I'm going to draw a box using my finger around the text that I want to read. Release my finger, and it's going to take a second for it to process that text, but then it's going to read it for me.
Cesar Chavez was born in Arizona. His family owned a farm and they had a good life. But in the 1930s, the Chavez family lost their farm.
And tap the button again, and it will stop reading. I can convert this text or level it by tapping the leveling tool, and you see that it makes those changes. So about halfway down, there is some italicized text that says low-paid traveling workers. Tap on that, and it converts to migrant. So all of the tools that are available for using accessible text are also available for me to use with the OCR tool. I'm going to go back to Safari one more time and show you the outlining feature. And I've already got a page open from the Time Machine, which is a passage of text I use to demonstrate reading, but also in building book reports. So again, send the text to Snap&Read. And once it's open, down in the bottom right-hand corner, I'm going to open the Study Guide Tools. And I've already started an outline on the Time Machine. Now I'm just going to close this window up, and I may know that, all right, if I'm going to do a book report in the Time Machine, I need to add the title. So I'm going to highlight the title. And on the right-hand side, the fifth button down, the iBeam tool, once I tap that, go back into the outline, it shows you that it's pulled in the Time Machine into my outline. Now I'm going to go back to the book, and this time I'm going to highlight and select the name of the author. Tap the iBeam tool, and I know that I also need to start collecting some character names, so I'm going to select the Time Traveler. Tap the iBeam tool. Go back into the outline, and all of these pieces of information have been collected for me. And I'm able to go ahead and modify that text if I choose to. I'm able to add extra blanks and enter text as I choose from the keyboard. So in short, all of the features that you're used to in Snap&Read Chrome extension are available to you in the Snap&Read iPad app.